Okay, there we go. I've thrown my self-promotion everywhere. Like the absolute whore for views I am. And it's fine, Raven. You go do your thing. You do your writing. Good luck with the writing. Sure be very fun. Well, let this play out for a bit, because you know, it's a legitty opening. It's an absolute banger, as the youth would say. Is my controller plugged in for this? Because this game is much better with the controller. Yes, it is. Fucking love Gundam. Yeah, this is the. It's one of the openings for the game. It's a really nice game. And also, I had a bunch of people follow me. You know, within the space of like 10 minutes, so I'm like, oh damn. That's really nice. More people. I love having more people around. I mean, I'm probably gonna get copyright hit for the, you know, this, but who gives a shit? I'm not gonna do. Kick me off Twitch, probably. It's good times. I know. Followers are great. I love having new people around. Hopefully, some of them will drop by, but I know they're watching a very nice cowtuber right now. And she's the reason that I got those followers. So, yeah. Okay, how's audio looking? Audio's looking alright. It's nice. Start a new game. I know I have like old save data, but we're gonna start from the very beginning. A cowtuber. She's a cow. The very nice cow. 10 out of 10 would pet that cow. Alright, get a bunch of stuff for starting the game. And having all the DLC. I know, character creation. Very nice. I play Overwatch with her now and then. We want to go to organization. Lists. Organized captures. Sell those for the big money. And you can't see my big money because my stuff is in the way. Understand what? Just move this out of the way. Oh, I didn't want to move that. I wanted to move that. I love how my money is just going in places. Hey, Cruel, it's going good. I'm just gonna leave it where it is. I have a lot of money. I think that's like 400 million money. Because you start with the game. Because starting the game gives you money. Because they're like, hey, you've got DLC. Here's money. So, I am going to offer people. Yes, I'm going to offer people. I could edit my thing right now. Man, I'm too lazy for that. You can create custom characters. Yes. Yeah, you have 25 custom characters. These can be mobile suit pilots or ship crew. Of course, I'm going to make myself. Yeah. There we go. It'll be myself. I am, of course, a dude. It does Americanization of month, day, year, or month, day. Glasses. You got different outfits, and you can hide the face, wear a helmet. You got a few different looks about. Each from different periods of Gundamization. Personally, I am old man. I feel like an old man inside, so there we go. We have different voices. There's a lot of voices. No, my character actually doesn't have glasses. No. I actually have glasses in real life. That I don't wear. So I need to buy new ones. Oh, we got... yes. Small town. Duh. We'll just go... over here. That one's fine. That one was me. Yes. You don't know that this man's about to beat your ass. Yes, gender birthday can't be changed. Raven, would you like to be a pilot? Would anybody actually that's here like to be a pilot? I'm more than happy to add them in. Alright, yeah. Add female. Alright. I have to always do a double check when typing people's names because my dyslexic ass will fucking fuck it up. Alright. Any particular date you want for your date of birth? Like, you know, just... October 31st, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Any particular also, dates also change character abilities, so... I'll just leave it on the unknown for fun times. Now we get your outfit. You want a shadowed face, or... shadowed face or revealed face? Shadow. Alright. You know, we have the obligatory Gundam lolly. We have all the fun times. Booba blonde. Alright, let me go find the Boba blonde. That one? Oh, red hair? You want her in a suit or without a suit? Because if you're a suit, you get a hat. Without suit? Alright. Let me just double check. Yeah, okay, just the one. Cool. And now we have to go through voices. It's gonna be fun. Okay, no, that's a lolly voice. No, I don't want. No. No. Yeah, there's a lot of voices to pick from. You got 20 of them. I think you got... Alright. That one, you want 20? 20 it is. We also have main themes. You can have a theme from different Gundams. I'm a sucker for the IBO themes. You want 69? We'll give you 69. What does 69 sound like anyway? That's 69. Oh, it's the Astro backgrounds. Fitting, since the Astro pilots were female. And since nobody else here wants one, we'll head those two. Alright, units. Oh, form groups. Sorry, mate, you're just going over here. Deploy. Because definitely creator characters have better, kind of better stat groupings. You don't have a suit, but we have some... Yeah, you can have this combat helicopter, dude. Hey, my G. Actually, I can probably make a unit. Alright, we got all the fun stuff. We got helicopters. Oh, yeah. Raven has a Gundam. Yeah, you're piloting a Phoenix Zero. That's your Gundam right there. I've got the Phoenix Gundam right now. Which is that boy. I mean, I could go ridiculous and we could... Oh. Me being dumbass and doing that. Go ridiculous and I could produce a couple of fun stuff. You got Jins and Zoot. Mobius and a bunch of other stuff. All from different areas. And it's, so for Gundam customization, you can, modify it. You can put, like, stuff like, you know, this one here, so you don't get XP for the Gundam. For some mysterious reason. Movement speed, accuracy, evasion, HP, and energy. Energy's always nice. There's also, you also have your raid group. Raid groups function so you have warship groups and raid groups. Warship groups, all about launching from a ship. They heal and they refuel the energy by going back on the ship. Raid groups can heal and refill energy outside, but they're also don't heal as much. Offense. I can make you an offensive Gundam then. You want offense? We can go with... Can you... Yeah, you can become other Gundams. But no, we'll start basic. We'll start real basic early steam. Alright, now we get to pick stories. And stories are always fun. Because we have Gundam Wing. Another Gundam Wing. Endless Waltz Gundam Wing. Gundam Seed, where you too can meet the Jesus of Gundam. The Astray series of Gundam Seed. More Gundam Seed. More Gundam Seed. Stargazer. Stargazer's pretty neat. Gundam 00. 00F. More 00. Yeah, IBO. So IBO early game is rough, because in the IBO universe, lasers, garbage, don't work. And then we have expansions, and expansions have this. A bunch of stuff. Oh no, I prefer starting from Gundam Wing, which is also my least favorite Gundam. Oh, start with Gundam Wing. On Dominic. Is... Oh yeah. Text. After colony. Sorefa. Voice actor text. There is reading in this game. If it's not voice actor, I won't read it. Chikuken Toys Rengo. Saying it to Heva no Nanomotori. But I. It's actually just the entire plot of Wing. You actually just play the plot of the universe, just with slight differences. It's what SD Gundam is all about. Oh, I forgot to do my custom soundtrack. It is what it is. Move that over there. Operation Meteo.
流星に偽装した新兵器ガンダムを地球へ送り込み、軍事秘密結社オズに。
But yeah, so this is basically the plot point of Gundam Wing. Space people send killing machines with children to Earth. Because, you know, why else would you send children to the planet? It's Gundam. Children committing war crimes is, like, peak Gundam. Now we get to a bit more plot, and then we get to actually fight something. Colonel Zex, sir. Oh my god. Oh god, it's going fast. Oh lord. Nope. Slow. Okay. So many meteorites on a wave directly into Earth's atmosphere. I can't do Zex's voice. I've not heard it dubbed. So, yeah. And a perfect match to the intel from Oz headquarters. This is clearly the work of the colony's Operation M. How many can our transport catch? Just one, sir. Just one is enough. Yes, Gundam Wing. A frontline soldier doesn't clamor for glory. The only redeeming quality to me from Gundam Wing is the fucking tall geese. That's like my... That's the only tolerable thing from Gundam Wing I like. I've said it before, I am a soldier. First and foremost. I just never got into the hype of Gundam Wing. The shooting star she saw. Thank you. When we come over to, I believe, yes, this, the transport. With this person. This fucking person. What's the matter, Relina? Is it so bad going back to Earth? Yeah, it really is. I mean, bro, I feel the same. Forgive me, I've been so busy with work. I should have spent more time with you. Father of the Year. Father, I think you could stand to relax a bit next time we're in space. You're right. For that brief moment before war crimes start happening. Father, what is that? I pressed A. I'm so used to just pressing A. A re-entry shuttle? No, I can't believe it. It's Operation Meteor. Hey, Juice! What? Colonel Zex, sir, we've caught up to it. Just as I thought, this is an egg of war from which our future conflicts will hatch. Bro, going in deep on these words here. It'll have to slow down in front of that civilian shuttle. But couldn't it shoot down the shuttle and accelerate? Too risky, too conspicuous with us right here. This mission must remain a secret after all. Zex just knows everything. This man is... he's ahead of the game. Did the Alliance pick me up? Of course they did. That's okay. We got Hiro Yui, the emotionless blank slate. Our target, it's accelerating, sir. It's in our line of fire. Perhaps the pilot has a death wish. Or they're going to use the element of surprise and escape. No, I don't believe so. I mean, a lot of people liked Hiro. I didn't. Then again, I came off the back of Gundam fucking 0079. Which is, you know, the original Gundam. So, you know, I came off a, you know, character that had a bit more emotional showing than Hiro at the start of Wing, where he's just kind of doing stuff and being like a stoic man's. New orders understood. I'll take down the transport immediately. I gotta pay attention. Boom! Look, it's the Gundam Wing! Colonel, what is that? So their new weapon is a fighter jet. Oh, my friend, if only you knew. I thought they were just delivering it, to think they would actually send a pilot inside. We can attack it. Machine guns should scare it off. No, this foe won't be frightened by such a thing. Is the Leo ready? A mobile suit against a jet? Indeed. But the Leo is meant for ground combat, sir. The high-speed area would be more suited for this, wouldn't it? My Leo is more than up to the task. Besides, it wouldn't do to refuse the challenge. Roger that. I'll use the Ares to hold it off until the Leo is ready, sir. Very well. Oh! We got some Ares, which are flying suits. We'll take care of it, Colonel. Our Ares will make short work of it. All this mobile suit sighted. Moving to destroy them. Let's go, hero. Let's go beat their fucking ass. Alright. We got some plot here. Destroy it. Destroy two Ares in the same turn. Easy enough. Oh! We gotta move. Right here. Hit him attack with the Buster Rifle. I will show you. This game has battle animations. I love this about this game. Battle animations. The poor fools. I would do it often. I would do it a super lot, but we have battle animations. And one shot, one kill. There's lots of different battle animations for all the different mobile suit attacks. Oh, that's one down, and one. Now, when you kill a dude, gauge, steps, you get a chance step. So, basically, you get to move and attack one more time. And you can do that twice. Oh, you can move like here. And pew! Dude's dead. Boom! Two in one turn. Challenge complete. Yeah. We get the fucking Zex's background music. You took out both Ares single-handedly. Very interesting. Gah, not bad. And boom! Now we get... Gundam Wing's mobile suit form. Instead of being a jet. Transformed into a mobile suit! Besides Alliance and ours, how could there be other people possessing the technology to make mobile suits? Moreover, that strength, could it be? What could it be, Zex? And then he kamikazes us to ensure that we crash. And then Zex is a little parachute. I like how there's actually a little sprite of Zex. Ooh, it's a little spread of them. Nope, it's just regular dude in parachute. Damn. But yeah, this game. Good times, good times. Colonel Zex, are you okay? Apologies for worrying you. I thought I might be able to help. I've analyzed the combat data. The sword strength from the enemy suit could only mean one thing. It's made from Gundanium alloy. I see, so we have ourselves a Gundam. The suit may be undamaged, but the recklessness surely cost the pilot his life. Let them know our quarry went down near the JAP point. Yes, Colonel, I'll collect it, sir. Thank you. So, Hero gets clapped, and he crashes. That's how it is. We then move on to some more slice of life coming up. Good to see you, Mr. Dalian. We've ready one of our military's vehicles for your time. Time is of the essence. Right now, that won't do. I've got to get ready for my daughter's birthday. Yes, it's very story heavy because they want you to go through the story of the animes. We've readied a vehicle for your daughter as well. No, there's no need to worry about me. I can find my own way. Relena, I'm sorry that my fatherly duties must take me away. Shall we be going? General Septim is waiting for you. Yes. I have stellar voice acting skills. 10 out of 10. Dot, dot, dot. Meanwhile, back on the plane. Three mobile suits were lost. Ah, yes, Trace. Yes, sir. It's unlike you to be so careless. It would be easy to keep the Alliance off our backs. The suit we faced was made of Gundanium. Come again? If this kind of weapon was built by the colonies, this entire mess could have been avoided. Only you and I had been in Oz 15 years ago. So it was indeed a Gundam. It's the only thing that makes sense. The Alliance has coddled the colonies. The Marina is attempting to cover the machine. Allow me to take care of that. I don't think I need to say we're at a critical point. It wouldn't do to poke the Alliance bear. Yes, sir, I understand. Hooray! Political drama and intrigue! True Gundam staples. Awaiting your orders, Colonel. No need to get yourself worked up. It won't be going anywhere. But, sir, let me show you something a bit more interesting. A photo. Oz Reconnaissance has been taking pictures. A striking resemblance to the machine we just formed, don't you think? Sir, please. Your panties are knotted. It's like, I don't even wear panties. What are you on about? You're not saying there are two of them? No, that's not all I'm saying. The mobile factory seized by Oz, the space pods. The team sent to investigate the capsules that touched down, all devastated, just as they were. Sometimes it is what it is, man. Which makes four. Five, if we include the one that went down. Five suits. Five Gundams? Oh no. We should thank our lucky stars to have survived a tussle with a Gundam. Look, slice of lifetime. Relena, staring longingly out at the beach. You know it's my birthday soon, don't you, Father? Any normal girl would have had a fit by now. I suppose it's fine. And not some child who doesn't understand how important his work is. I guess I should head home. Is that a person? A soldier, but he's a child. Welcome to Gundam, Relena. Child soldiers are the norm. And my name is John Cena. He had to put his hand in front of his face. Just hold still. I'll call for help. Did you see? See what? Wait! My name is Relena Dalian, and you are... Meanwhile, in another place. Excuse my tardiness, sir. General Trays, am I right in hearing that your subordinate lost three mobile suits during re-entry? You are, sir. Your point being... Three suits wasted for what? To stop some rebel? As a result, we're able to put a stop to their pilot. You think I'm talking about results? Where is it you think the true strength of the Alliance lies? The true strength? Suppose I should say the soldiers? Or with our mobile suits, perhaps? I know all she wants is a Gundam. Then, Father, give me a Gundam. You dare mock me? I, Uriel Septim, leader of the Empire of Cyrenal. Couldn't resist. Field Marshal Noventa. Let's all settle down, he says. This will not be our last engagement, General. I suggest you exercise caution. Yes, sir. The Alliance has grown too accustomed to peace. The future is ours to make. It lies with us. With Oz. With the Aussies. Oz is just Australia, bro. Always has been. Back to slice of life suddenly. We get some political intrigue, some slice of life, some politics, and then we're back to slice of life. Gundam Wing, everybody. It's a new semester. But it's that day that keeps coming back to me. Hiro Yui. It's him. The transfer student. Hiro Yui. I like how Hiro Yui is the protagonist for Gundam Wing, but he was never but before him he was actually not meant to be the protagonist. He actually didn't exist for like majority of Gundam Gundam Wing's like creation. He came in at a later point. It was actually a different character that was meant to be the protagonist. Hiro. I'm going to kill you. What? What are you? He has so many secrets. Yeah, Hiro Yui was never meant to be the protagonist for Gundam Wing. It was meant to be somebody else. But the main character became a side character, and then we got Hiro Yui. He is so... Yes. Can't you tell she likes this man? She met this man and she wants his babies. Secrets. Did I figure him out? And now he's going to kill me? What are you saying, Hiro? Who are you going to kill? Who is Hiro going to kill? Meanwhile, in another place. In Kosuka. We get lots and lots of dudes. And a zeppelin. Well, it's a blimp. Come on, dude. It's too dangerous to fly a blimp in this. We have, like, walking mechs, but they still use a blimp. Because blimps are cool, dude. Idiot, this is the best way to show the enemy and the specials that we mean business. By flying a blimp. We don't need help from them or anybody. This is just an excuse they need to stick their noses in. Hey bro, you're in a blimp. You can't really do much, mate. So, the commander's indisposed? My apologies, Colonel. I'd heard that he disliked me, but... I'm terribly sorry, sir. Never mind, it's not entirely unwarranted. Colonel Zex! Lieutenant Walker, it's been some time. You haven't changed a bit, Colonel. Walker, you wouldn't happen to have a mobile suit for me. Funny you mention that. There's something you need to see. Something you want to show me? Hey, it's the tall geese! This is... They say it's the ancestor of all mobile suits. And it's a class above the Leo, size-wise. It's an antique, but when I saw your data from the Gundam, I remember we had it stored as a historical artifact. So... In the Wing universe, the Tall Geese was the first ever mobile suit made. And you're from Corsica, aren't you? Stationed there, sir. It's the only unit with armor that held up against the data. I was never told what went into building it myself, but it had to be massive to get that kind of power. Too big, really. Word is, they downsized it when they standardized the current line of suits. The Tall Geese. I think that's what they called it. Tall Geese. And it would be a match for a Gundam when it's finished? No question, sir. Colonel, I'd like you to take this one from the factory. Are you expecting to die, Walker? It's like you told me, sir. Everything I do is for the soldiers who come after me. Then you've become a braver soldier than I am. So, how many are we expecting? The maximum, sir. Just like you taught me. Four, then. One of them won't be coming here. That's all the intel I have. I'm sorry, Walker. I'll be glad if we can get even one, Colonel. So yeah, Tall Geese, my favorite mobile suit from Wing. Listen up, these specials think the battlefield is just some namby-pamby game. They're aching to kill each other so bad they'll fire things up themselves. But we will not agitate. Stay calm and we will avoid any unnecessary confrontation. We're going to show these bloodthirsty specials how to fight. Commander, we must stop this. One hit from the enemy and the blimp. What enemy? Who'd be foolish enough to hit a patrol? Behold. Somebody foolish enough to hit the patrol. Look, it's the guy that was actually meant to be the protagonist for Gundam Wing. Trower. Commander, we're under attack. I'm not getting anything on radar. Settle down, it's only one unit. These damnable machines. Surround it and destroy it. Tactically speaking, the best option against small numbers is to cut off their retreat and bathe them in concentrated fire. In which case, the commander made the right choice in choosing to surround and destroy me. That said, they would have done better to gauge my strength before acting. What is this? How could I have miscalculated so badly? Cover the commander's retreat. The rest of you, attack the enemy. Fools! It's a strong one. Looks like we're not going to be making it out of here. Make sure the data team at the factory gets all the logs. For the soldiers of the future. Gah, I'm sorry. And then he fucks off. Right, bring it in. Focus on the fight. That's everything. Alright. Oh! Now we get to actually use our own mobile suits. Oh! You bring in ship group. And the B location, bring in our raid group. Boom! Everybody's in. So we can start the fight. I need to remember what the special conditions are. Can you destroy at least 10 enemy turns? Units within 3 turns? Easy enough. But first thing is move ship. Finalize. Alright, send out Phoenix Gundam. We'll do a feather funnel. Oh, of course, kept my custom music for this one. Nice. This is the, actually the music from, one of the musics from, oh god. The audio quality is a bit off how loud it is, but it's the, it's actually one of the soundtracks from the first game for our custom pilots. But we're going to just do this. Yeah, let's see if Raven can hit somebody after I missed. Hey, hit him. It's a lot of damage. So essentially, ships. You launch your dudes, and you got good old big attacks. That's how it is. Attack with ships, and you keep attacking with your ship. Raid groups are more are definitely good early on, but later the harder difficulties they kind of fall off, mostly due to how their healing and energy refill works. That's not being super strong. Diffuse beam. Have you seen that diffuse beam? It blows up. Helicopter with missiles to you. Right, that's everybody from the ship launched. Raid groups, yep. So, with raid groups, they have these little yellow squares. Yellow squares? Heal. Energy refill. You stand next to a friendly, you lose some energy regen? Hey, Fanboys Prime. Yes, I've actually played this game before in the other games. It's a fun game. I love it. I'm starting a new game. Standing over here, you get health and energy. But we're just gonna keep moving forward. Because these guys are slow. Like, with the ship launch, they can't keep up. And we move my boy Heavy Arms up. We'll go with the All Out. Use All Out, just, you know. For nice. Now that we've seen this unit, I can't let you live. There's no surviving this kind of fire now. Good old Heavy Arms. Just... I'm gonna go for the Astro. I like the Astros. I believe I am... What an active unit. Oh yeah, you. I usually end up going for like my favorite suits first, honestly. But I tend to try and at least collect one of every suit at some point in the game. Alright, I believe that's all my dudes. Pass. Evade. Skip that. Evade. We'll counter you with that. Evade. Counter. Alright. That should be good. Let me just bring ship up a bit. But too far away. We'll get there in the end. Alright, move over to here. Beam saber this land. I wish we did get fucking G Generations Genesis on PC. I love that one. Yeah, it was a really fun game. Okay. Some of the voice lines of this, man. Oh. Peak Gundam. Beam Saber support from yeah. Mega Beam Cannon. Mega Beam Cannon, go! Oh, it's hit that attack. What? Hey! Boom! Stick chance! Oh, I will have to take this music off. Because I know that the song is copyright. Attack. Mega Beam Cannon here. No, this particular song is not. Other songs are, I forgot I had this one still equipped. I thought, you know, starting a new game, it would unequip it, but nope. This song is actually... Yeah, so, good times. Short amounts of missiles. Move tornadoes up. More defuse. Did I want to get those guys out? I'm trying to kill like 10 people really damn quick. I always boost energy in this game. Alright, gonna go up. I got a knife. Now this one's fine. This one's fine. He got a big knife, and he's gonna give it a good shank. I've never played 13 Sentinels. What's that like? But also, G-Generation's Genesis would be really nice. Because, where Crossroads does the alternate timelines, Genesis does the main timeline of Universal Century. Pew pew. Bullets. Okay. Cool. Yeah, I'm gonna deal with that a bit. Nice. That actually sounds really cool. I'll have to look at that. Oh yeah, you'll notice the get gauge, which is basically just you fill that up, you get the mobile suit. But also you can just develop the mobile suit on your own. From just getting leveling up suits to different levels. I'll go into that after the mission and I can like show some of it. I could talk about what I'm actually trying to describe because I'm terrible at explanations. Two enemy turns, two more enemies. Alright, move you up there. Attack. You. We've seen this attack like a bunch. Move all. There we go. Because red groups are slow, and I hate dealing with red groups. Put them back on the ship. Kind of use beam rifle. Shoot him back. Counter you with shoulder missiles. Counter you with shoulder missiles. Ow. Pain. Pain and suffering. But he gets energy back. So, one of the cool things about raid groups, though, is you get, let's just move. Here. You can do this. And you get raid attack, you get group attacks. So the entire group gets to go at once and do like a big group attack. Same thing happens with worship links. Two down. He took out two, he missed one. I'll show a warship and couple when I can get around to that. Also, a good thing about group attacks is the entire group gets XP for damaging units. And we got the historic moment. Because, you know, historically, Showa absolutely dominated this fight. Without the help of mysterious interdimensional travelers. People have made it safely. Colonel Zex, he's taken Leo. Odo, please, don't make this any harder for me. But sir, protecting the Torgis, that is the mission I've decided to undertake. I'm sorry, I'm going to need you to join me. Yes, sir. Good old Otto. Is that from Oz? The Australians. Let's go, then. And then they bugger off. And then we get more people to fight. There's a lot of fighting. Too many. But don't worry, we get help. And the Thorn of Sandrock. Of Quatre. A couple homies. It's wrong. We shouldn't be fighting, not you and I. There we are, some more people to fight. I would say again, get out of your suit. And in another place, at a different time, we get another suit doing another suit thing. Lake Victoria. Captain Noan, we got Colonel Zex on the line. Colonel Zex, put him through. Yes, ma'am. At last. It's been a while, Colonel Zex. You've hardly changed, Noan. I've heard you've been hard at work. I've heard tales of the lightning counter all the way here in Victoria. I do hate when rumors precede me. Enemies paint targets on you and allies. Start to expect things. Rumors are wonderful things. Have you heard about me? Only that you're turning out a fine crop of zero-G pilots. Crafting the perfect combatants. But I have to ask Noan. You always hated war. Why expend all of this effort? I'm honored you even remember that about me. Well, I'm rather fond of space. Crack goes my drink. And those zero-G mobile suits? The Tauruses believe that we're already being targeted. I've heard that they don't show up on radar. We've got some troops on the lookout. Fresh from training, but they'll do. Fantastic, though you always were. I do appreciate the compliment, Colonel Zex. No need for titles, Noan. Mind you, becoming too attached will just make leaving harder. Thank you for your concern, but I'll have you know, I don't train soldiers to die. Recklessness never makes for good strategy. War can never compare to the value of life. Having seen soldiers die on my watch, I have to say, I disagree, Noan. Putting your life on the line only ends in mistakes. Soldiers cornered, dying. I pity them. You've made your point, Nolan. We can discuss it next time. We've got some rare cargo here. I was hoping you might be able to take us on. Understood, sir. Well then, I'm counting on you. Zex, 1 year and 22 days. Yep. God. What? What happened? I forgot the name of the Gundam. An enemy attack. A direct hit on the trainee barracks. What? Search and destroy. Destroy them all. They should be right at our doorstep. Boom. Get out, man. Woofei. Enemy unit spotted. I think it's a Gundam. What? They're after the Tauruses. Dispatch all personnel. Leos, cover the area. I'll lead the mobile suits myself. Get some Leos and a couple of Ares. Come on and show yourself, Gundam. Thought you were that dirty, eh? Why not hit the mobile suits when you can take the pilots? You call yourself a man? Feels like I've heard that before. A soldier? He's just a boy. How could one boy do all of that? One kid on a suicide mission. Can't be a day over 14. A woman? No wonder you're weak. Whoa, Wufei! Whoa! It's 2022! Oh, thank you for the tip, Raven. Oh, throwing your money at me, wasting it all. How could you? It's enough out of you. All units have only got one enemy. Focus all your fire on him. Follow me. Oh no, this one should be fine, because it's a business account, and they expect me to get money for things. Hopefully. Yep, you get secret units. And map toggles. Alright, now we have two maps we're fighting on. We're fighting on this map, we get Chang Wufei being a misogynist. Since, you know, it's the current year, Wufei, you can't be saying that now. But man, the Shenlong Gundam is really strong. I'm editing before I just get shut down by PayPal again. It'd be hilarious. But no, it should be fine. I'll put an end to these chaotic times! I do like the Shenlong Gundam. It's pretty nice. But yeah, you really don't have to give me money. And then we go back here to do more fighting. But yeah, getting Wufei's mech is really damn easy. We'll move you back. We'll move up here, because she's really dumb as a captain. Oh yes, quickly. We will cure his misogyny by making him have a lot of female companions. Perfect. Alright. So, Heavy Arms is one of my other favorite Gundams. I will. You just need to recharge your energy. Because the only way warship units refill energy is via, going back to the ship and charging up their batteries. It's gonna plug you into a wall socket somewhere. Like, oh my god, is your Gundam USB-C compatible? I'm sorry, it uses Thunderbolt. Oh. Yeah. Just chill here. And then we come up here, because I always forget about the dudes up here. We've got Sandrock. And Sandrock, he comes with his own little raid group as well. We just go over here and raid Link. We just boop it to Smaximus, these dudes. I like Sandrock. Sandrock's pretty nice too. But, Quatre is kind of... His last name is Winner. You know this man's winning in life when his last name is Winner. I forget that his last name's Winner. It's like, are you winning, son? Yes. My name is Winner. But like... Quatre is kind of like, he's really hard to describe. Because he kind of just becomes an asshole later. And he shoots some rockets. Quatre dodges rockets. Because he's a winner. And winners don't get hit by rockets. This guy's got a fucking tomahawk that has fire on it. The heat tomahawk. He's gonna shoot some- Oh no, he's gonna do gun, not rocket. But, Magnax? Alright. And we hit him with the beam rifle. And he gets a bit hurty hurt. I think that's everything. No, we got two inactive units. There we go, yeah, you too. And then that should be everything. Evade, please. Evade. Alright, then they can kind of hatch. By full open hatching that. Sure, dude. Yeah, kind of that. Hatch full open. Evade. Evade. He got hit. Evade. He got hit. That man's dead. That man died. He died for our sins. Show the Dragon Fang. Show you the Dragon Fang. Ducka 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 ducka. Dragon Fang. He shoots hand. Man literally shoots hand at people. Well, child. Local child shoots hands. Evade. Counter with Dragon Fang fire. Dragon Fang Fire is more time, more fun. Also, I saw the message, I love you too, Raven. Because me being blind, I didn't realize that there was a message attached to the tip. Bum, 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 bum. Okay, we're going over here. Maybe here, beam glaive. Beam glaive.
A beam glaive.
I will resume the beam glaive attack. Okay. Hold up. Hey-yah.
Okay, never mind.
I missed that call. It was probably my grandmother trying to tell me stuff I already know. Go up. Let's keep going up this side. Finalize. PB rifle. Oh, no, no, ah! Hey, level up.
You're the hit! There we go.
Send a raven to beat this man's ass.
Go raven, beat their ass.
Man's dead, Raven. You've killed the man. How do you feel today?
Let's keep moving and fighting them. And... Oh yeah, Road Link.
That man's dead. Oh my god, that man's alive.
Also, a lot of the tracks in this game absolutely slap.
Half gets hit. Are you here? To here. What's your range? You're fine.
Otherwise, do we have anybody else that can come out? Yeah, dude in the helicopter. Shoot this. Miss. Mega beam cannon, Raven again.
Zero level 2, Raven the level 2, leveling up slowly, Sandrock, Raid, confirm, kill those guys real quick, high speed, high kills. Heat show towards it. Show that the heat shoulders will attack. That
Oh man, more than an hour into the stream. I'm gonna let the two homies heal. Okay. Here. Alright. And then new round. Hit. Oh, shit. Oh, HP. Oh, yep. Oh, Beam Saber. Beam Saber attack, go! Counter with the rifle. Dangerous times. Oh. Don't die, Raven. Oh yeah, well, time for more misogyny from Buffet. The battlefield is no place for women. Damn, Buffet, chill. Well, I hope everybody's having a good day, night, evening, afternoon, early morning, wherever your time zones are. Oh no! Oh no! 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 Fuck. Hey Joker, F in the chat for Raven's mobile suit. She got yeehawed. I'm about to be yeehawed. Level 1 mobile suits just aren't really, early mobile suit. These mobile suits aren't really good early game. Oh well, we can do some worship attacks. Yeah, you know, it's just like, you know, you take like a level 1 unit out to do something. Do that, yeah. Warships can also attack. I love carry bases. Pew, pew. Beans. Of course, you know, ship shooting really big guns at that dude is not really gonna go well. But hey, you know, worth a shot. Rockets! He misses! And then he nearly dies. Walker's gone. I don't wonder why he's doing so well. It's Oswald. Dog! You're my chilling! Don't scratch. Don't like... hit my door. It's annoying. Don't need maintenance on them. Over here. Attack with beam. And then... yeah, early game mobile suits. Everybody, well, they all just die in like seconds. Destroy that dude, and we gotta send him back to the ship. Send me back to the ship. Reflexes. Oh, mate. Too tempting not to use. Nope. Low alert. And supercharged. And back into the ship. And we're gonna move you up to here. So just be a weak shield for the poop. There we go. You guys are just gonna chill here. Finalize. Move all. Kill these guys. Jump back over here. Take the buddy Shenlong around the building to smack no one in the booty. For more fun times. Yeah, more Shenlong just telling a woman where she can be. Yeah, 666 damage. That's Shenlong for you. That's what he does. Kind of an asshole. This was like 14. Just kind of dumb. Move. What's wrong with you, Ares? You, woman, do you hear me? Going easy on a child. Say that makes you a pretty poor soldier. I won't be killed by women or weaklings. No! Yeah. He's kind of a dick. He's like, I won't be killed by women. Ha! It's... you know, the homie for you. Yeah, supercharged. We get super crits now. Now we got him to do this. Does he get special animation for super crits? I forgot if he does. No, he doesn't. What does he? I don't remember. Super crit, 10,000 damage, one shot. And then we go back to here. Use you, move. Fucking. Let the homies do their attacks. But how are you, King Jerker? Having a good day. Ba-ba. Oh,
Man had a bad day. Man didn't do too well. Let me just move all the way back over here and finalize here. Leave you here to stand next to the bro and heal. Let him just counterattack. Defense. You guys are healing up. Oh. Set myself back out. Just for the beams, we're just gonna warship raid this dude. Just with like everybody. Cause I love showing off warship raid. Or warship group attacks. You get all of the clover suits doing little floaty rounds and shooting things and going pew pew. Bam. Pew pew. Good times, good times. But yeah, I forgot how long missions take in this game. They take forever. Like, oof. It's been like an hour and a bit on this mission. They're long missions, so... Yeah. It's been a hot minute. And a neck minute. More unit levels. Shank him. It should be last unit. Super high. Hatch full open. And it should be the last enemy, and it should be end of mission. Right. Yep, end of the mission. We will need a new Gundam. Hopefully. For, Raven. No one, are you alright? Yeah, banged up in body and mind, though. No one, I'm just glad you're alive. No worries about me getting promoted over you now, eh? A joke? Now I'm sure you're fine. Zix, let me fight alongside you. I need to stop being so naive. That Gundam really got one over me, on me. But next time it's going to be a different story. Zix, I'd be grateful to have you working with me. Zix, thank you. Meanwhile, in another place. Hey, come in, hero. Stoicism. Jeez. You see, we're making an effort here, right? I mean, come on. I told you I'd fix up your mobile suit and everything. And all you can say is, no? No one touches my suit but me. End of story. How about this, smart guy? Where are you going to get the parts? I don't care how good a tech you are. You can't fix diddly if you don't have the parts. Got that? Ha. Huh. Why did I have to save you, of all people? Mr. Brash McSurley over here. This sucks. You want to be all doom and gloom? Why not just screw off and be a hermit somewhere? Hey! What, a little too late to ask me for help? Think you could shut up? Whatever, man. Sorry I even said anything. Fucking angsty teenagers, dude. What? A mission. The enemy's on their way for shipment of Gundanium. Roger that. Executing tomorrow morning. You know, kind of hard pulling off a mission in a busted suit. Pretty much impossible, right? For you, maybe, not for me. Alright. My deepest apologies, sir. You screw up, you blow up, missions you can't fail. like two peas in a pod, you and I. Back somewhere else. What is happening here? Slice of life, hero. Just come and kill me already, hero. Relena, that's, I mean, you know, I kind of wish he did, but, you know, that's how it is. Yeah, XP, kills, money. I'm gonna need some challenges and a secret and stuff, so we get stuff. And get information. Later stage, we'll be Sodi Warship and Regroup, which means we get the Jin Long Range and the Grey Space. As well as the Birdlime Launcher. Yeah. Alright, so, organization. Form groups. Raven no longer has a mobile suit. But if I go here, we do hit all designs. Make some tornado guns. Nice. Now we go to develop though. What is develop doing? No exchange. They can exchange it for like the Leo AWAC. But, eh. But if we go to develop, different mobile suits become different other suits. Depending on their level. Fun times. None of the suits are currently leveled high enough for it, but, you know. One day they will be. But we can also just make some mobile suits. I would definitely make some of these, but to be fair, they're incredibly broken for like the start. I definitely will make a gray space type. I love grays. We'll make two gray space types. And then we'll go back here. You get info. Bunch of knowledge. About producing stuff. What's the next mission? Atmospheric and ground. We need mobile suits that can go into the air. I don't think grazers can do air. No, they're not. They're space. Anybody atmospheric in here? Hellion. Tornado. Oh yes, these upgrade. Except for Destiny Gundam. Destiny Gundam is just Destiny Gundam. It does whatever it wants. Got a lot of Astray. Can become really nice beefy stuff. Sure, I'll make one. Make one Gundam Astray. Move you. Give you the Raven. Deploy. Get a Mastray. Keep you around. Now I want to go here. Oh yes, get great custom, yes, yes. Manage, produce, and say. Do I have to take it on one? Thank you for reminding me. Design. I love Grace Custom. I'll make it Grace Custom as well. And then, Because I'm just going to just be doing this. That's these, right? Because I'm lazy right now, we'll just send you off. Oh. Oh. Hey, you know, you learn from your mistakes. Well, that was one you could, like, get down to zero, but I didn't have enough dispatch items. I forgot about that. Eh, you live, you learn. But hey. I know the way you have multiple cooldown items. That reminds me. I got some random characters, because, you know, we need to spend money somehow. And then, I also do want another carry base. I hate raid groups, to be honest. And you will become worship group. And you can just have that. And you can just have that. And then we need command for ships. Anybody? So get you're the best at command, you can get that. Then I forgot what XOs need. So it's command as well. Oh, well. True. Then you are communication, the comms. Navigation. Mechanic. And guess, which is charisma. There we go. Actually, we also form another. Let's do another raid group. Why not? You guys will end up being just the group I send on mission to do dumb stuff. It's characters you want to work. Yeah, sure. I also gotta go here, change. There we are. And then go back and. Though I do have to call it because I gotta have fucking dinner. In like half an hour. So I will be calling that soon. Oh yeah, he's on mission. Can't change his background music. Ugh. Double R.
Which 00 is it? Is it Trailblazer? Trailblazer, right? There you are. Let it do auto talky talk.
その姿を現した施設武装組織ソレスタルビーイング。彼らは機動兵器ガンダムによる戦争根絶を掲げ、武力介入を開始。争いの絶えない世界のあり方を急変させました。
I've actually never watched 00.
機動エレベーターを中心にした。
Well, not the movie anyway. Watch the TV series.
その恩恵を求め、三つの超大国に分化されていた世界。
Thank you for your guidance, Prime.
旧国家軍を統合した地球連邦政府の樹立へとつながっていきます。世界の統一、それこそがソレスタルビーイングの本懐でありました。しかし、彼らソレスタルビーイングが目指していた変革の陰には。大きな歪みが潜んでいたのです。リボンズ・アルマーク、ソレスタルビーイングの創設者、イオリア・シュヘンベルグによって生み出されたイノベイド。その一人である彼は、自らを人類を超えた存在と語り、連邦政府の裏側から世界のすべてを管理しようと暗躍。一度は壊滅に至ったソレスタルビーイングもイノベイドに対抗すべく活動を再開。そして人類初のイノベーターへと覚醒を始めたガンダムマイスター刹那 F 精鋭の活躍により、リボンズの存在を退けたのです。その後、さまざまな思惑から脱却した人類は、自分たちの意志によって武力に頼らない社会を選択しました。世界は緩やかに争いのない未来へ歩み出そうと動き始めたのです。人類の革新へ新たな一歩を踏み出すように。しかし、それはあまりにも短く、その終わりを迎えることになります。地球から遠く離れた太陽系第五惑星木星、そこには130年前に行われた探査計画の末、木星軌道上にて崩壊した探査船の姿がありました。もう動くことのないその探査船は歴史上の遺物となり、遠い昔に人々から忘れ去られた存在でしたが、突然かつての姿を取り戻して地球圏へと向かい始めたのです。それは生存者のいない無人の船体がまるで一つの意志を宿したように。
But I love Gundam. Gundam is such a great series.
西暦2314年、それは人類の誰もが予想していなかったファーストコンタクト。人類という種に与えられた可能性が変革への帯同となり、今動き始めようとしていました。
Like a classic. Invasion time. Oh, a
assembly member booked here. The colony developed in its early stages, and there are so many dangers. In your position as representative of the Middle Eastern delegation, we cannot risk anything happening to you. The majority of the workers were forced to move here under Middle Eastern policies of the previous administration. As if some of them wish to return to their home country. I'm sure they do. Here at the Colony Public Corporation, we provide workers with the environment, provide blah blah blah, federal law. Besides, I can't imagine anyone who quit such a high paying job. Well, man, if the job is shit, people probably would quit. It's all about that. That's, then why can't we? Like I said, it's dangerous. I fully understand your position. It's impossible. Oh, if it's possible, maybe meet the workers and their families. We'd like to hear what they have to say. What they have to say? Very well. We should incorporate a visit to the workers' housing into your schedule. Thank you very much. We're changing your inspection route to see the workers' housing. A mining asteroid? Who would build housing facilities in such a place? What's going on here? Sorry, I don't know. What are your thoughts on this colony development site? It meets the working conditions required by federal law, but I'd like to hear what you really feel. I certainly wish for the citizens of the Middle East to be happy. I also wish the same for you. If my family is happy, then I am happy. Princess Marina. This is the captain. Attention all passengers. Unidentified mobile suits are approaching. As a precaution, we ask you to fasten your seatbelts. Mobile suits? Oh, those dudes. That's... Are those mobile suits from the Colony Public Corporation? What's going on here? I don't know. This is unthinkable. Are they going to attack us? Battle! Glorious battle has been joined, brothers! A flag. Target confirmed, now destroying the targets. Enjoying it throughout the Middle East. I can do my best. I won't let you. Oh yeah, these key drives. Oh my god. That's a lot of get. Real damn quick. Holy snap. Damn. Damn it. Oh well.
a gun. I just have to. With this, you believe your family will be happy? Gah. Bang! Ugh. The attack didn't work. So now you try assassination? That said, CPC is going a bit overboard. Who are you? No one worth mentioning. Take care. Dude just fuck. Comes over, shoots a dude, refuses to elaborate, leaves. Is that so? Man, you're dense, even though you're an innovator. Oh yeah, they're like the new types in this are like called innovators or whatever. I had no idea they were still active. Even now, they're fighting against the world. Celestial being. Damn. I don't know, it's just a dude. There's a dude in a suit. Not God, but you know. Identified the exploration ship currently approaching the Earth sphere. Registration number 9374. Vessel name Europa. The ship left Jupiter about 130 years ago on an exploration mission. An exploration mission 130 years ago? Why has it returned now? Any info on its interior? There are no life signs, so it's just a big, dangerous chunk of debris. We have to change the space shuttle's course. We'll proceed with Plan D-34. Attack with particle missiles. Roger. Spaceship sauce. Sussy ship. Deep space vessel, celestial being. So this is a deep spaceship built by Celestial B. That is a name. Aeolia Scheinberg? Scheinberg? Sorry, I'm not German. I don't speak the German. Or well, whichever part of Europe that name actually comes from. Founder of Celestial B was concocting this plan almost 3 centuries ago. Colonel! It's Brigadier General to you. How many years must you get us wrong? So sorry. You've come at a good time. You can be my escort. I'll be listening. It'll be a learning opportunity for you. Understood. It's an honor to have you come out here in person, General. It's all to have you come out here in person, General. What's the condition of the facilities? Ma'am, many aspects of the system environment are unique and complicated, not to mention its sheer size. Our assessment of the ship's condition is now 70% complete. 70%? Oh, what's that? Quantum processing system, Veda. Yes, that's what it is. Whoa, what's this? They've got the same face. Where Vader's living terminals, where Innovades. Innovades? Through the Innovades, Vader gathers information from around the world. It then integrates and manages it. So it's a super big AI with a bunch of human computers. Okay. 7 years ago, the private armed organization Celestial Being was able to carry out all those armed interventions because Vader was backing them. Today, we're also benefiting from this system. And the other thing we discussed? Of course, I'll show you the way. Damn, Double R. You got some wacky shit out here. Also got some really nice designs. I like them. Mission complete. Thanks to Vader's information, we're able to prevent anything from happening. You did a fine job, Setsuna. No worries, King. I'll be like finishing up in half an hour to go have food, then I'll probably be back and I might stream something else for a little bit today. So it'll be 2 years since the new administration took over. We have no choice but to clean up little problems. If we bring out the Gundams, they'll be a deterrent to the world. Milena, right now, when the government is pushing a conciliation policy, we'd only be disrupting their efforts. That's right, it's best if we just remain quiet and present. Until the moment we're needed again. Mr. Pierre had a report from Vader. It says the Federation forces are removing a spacecraft headed for the Earth sphere. Removing a spacecraft? Do we know where it came from? From Jupiter. Can we get detailed data on that aircraft? On that spacecraft? Setsuna. I'll see what I can do. Is something bothering you about this, Setsuna? Let me know as soon as you find something. Roger. There's something mysterious about Mr. lately. Setsuna has become an innovator. The new breed of human predicted by that person. He could be feeling something we wouldn't even understand. Bro, I've got some real emotions right now. You don't understand. This way. You're the one. A true innovator. Confirmed by Vader. Well, say something. Introduce yourself to the Colonel. Brigadier General! Oops, I'm sorry. Captain Descarte Sharma. Shaman. Shaman. They tell me that I'm an innovator. An impertinent one. I became one after continually being treated like a guinea pig. What's an innovator? You don't even know that? Reading reports isn't quite my thing. In simple terms, an innovator is an evolution of the human species. With greater situational comprehension, spatial awareness, quantum brainwaves, and physical enhancements due to cellular changes. They're superhumans. Theoretically speaking, they may have a lifespan twice that of the average person, and they live for 200 years. Cool. In addition, within an area where GN particles are spread, they can share their consciousness using quantum brainwaves. They're telepathic too. They do everything. These are the people you want to do everything. I don't understand one bit of that. Do you believe the appearance of innovators was part of this person's plan all along? In my personal opinion, I believe so. Reporting communications from Patrol Fleet. All GN missiles have hit the target. Roger that. Confirm the change in exploration ship's course. They failed. What? How do you know that? There's no logical reason, but I have a conviction. I have the conviction that it's true. Reporting. The course change is less than 20% of what was expected. Still on course to reach the Earth sphere. That can't be. They fired plenty of particle missiles at it. What are they doing? I'm going out. You are? Don't you want to see the true power of an innovator? What do you? Naturally, I'm taking the new model, just like you're hoping. You're reading my mind. I'm a guinea pig, after all. Damn, dude. Just reading people's minds without permission. Absolute rudeness. Third wave particle missiles have all hit their target. And its course? It's still on course to hit the Earth sphere. Grr, where are the mobile suits? They're chasing after it, but... Ooh, fancy. The ship is too big. Don't give up. Damn it. The reason most of our particles will thrust, we lack the power to. Huh? A friendly machine? Quantum Bravery Control System, all clear. I'm taking out all the anger I've held in on you. Oh my god. Damn, dude. Man has no chill. Just deleted the ship, but ship still sucks. What incredible performance. So that's the power of a suit made for innovators. Fermi exploration ship's destruction. All fragments of a shattered ship will be burned up in the atmosphere. Your thoughts? I see. It's clear why the military has such high expectations for Captain Sharma. Then let's treat him like your captain. Yes, understood. We've got a report. I see some fragments of the ship reached Earth without burning. What? They fell? Dispatch a collection team to recover those fragments immediately. Yes, ma'am. Why? Why did they fall? Brother, why didn't they burn up? Sauce! As we fought, there are no special characteristics to note. While these fragments fail to burn up in the atmosphere and make it to the Earth's surface, in all probability, it's due to the mass of the spacecraft. Billy! It would also explain why the exploration ship barely changed its course after receiving a barrage of particle missiles. In other words, the spaceship had a mass far greater than we could have imagined. It was incredibly heavy. Ah, Billy, you've come to see me, haven't you? Jumping to conclusions as usual, you never change. So let me hear your opinion. As an astrophysicist, have you analyzed the fragments? Aside from a small amount of cosmic radiation, we found nothing particularly unusual about the composition or structure. Very interesting results, I must say. But you know, Billy, the fragments we collected amount to less than 20% of what fell to Earth. I wonder if someone took the rest. I can think of two other explanations. The fragments could have spontaneously vanished or moved under their own power. You're really something, Billy. Look at the locations the fragments fell. These inexplicable accidents have been happening. That's close. Assuming the fragments are moving, where could they be heading? I have a hypothesis, but could you help me substantiate it? What do you need? The Federation government's confidential information. I need a database of citizens with high levels of quantum brainwaves. The element need to become innovators. I see. Let's get started then. Sus. Going down to Earth? I'm concerned about the fragments that fell to Earth. Do you seriously believe that those fragments are attacking humans with high levels of quantum brain waves? It's confirmed information from Vader. That's true, our comrades could be in danger as well. But come on, this is chunks of a spaceship. What could it do? They didn't burn up. Well, yeah, I guess there's something off that. I'll take a small craft. Whoa, slow down there. We need to hurry. Understood, Sitsuda. I'll leave the fieldwork to you. Get in contact with Aleluya? Too? He's still on the surface. These names, dude. Roger that. Like, I'm gonna sit here and I'm just gonna fucking fail at pronouncing the entire time. Lieutenant General Kim, my apologies for calling out here so suddenly. Not to worry, you've analyzed the fragments, yes. This man's been sent here on short notice from the Federation Assembly. I'm Presidential Special Envoy Klaus Grad. What's the current situation? Right, take a look at this. Oh, damn! This is... What happened? Here are just the facts. Nearly half the subject, or rather, this girl's body's tissue, has been changed to metal. That's fucking brutal, dude. Metal? Extraterrestrial living metal shapeshifter. We have named this alien entity ELS. Dude, that's fucking wild. The ELS before us has ceased all activity, and therefore it is impossible to determine its biological structure. However, the evidence suggesting they're attracted to humans who emit quantum brainwaves. In other words, those with elements that make them potential innovators are being targeted. Targeted? Assemblymember Grant, please propose to the Federation Assembly that all such people... Yeah, that is pretty metal, dude. You become metal. You become the mosh pit. Assemblymember Grad, please propose to the Federation Assembly that all such people should be evacuated to quantum brainwave isolation facilities. Understood. I'll do that right away. So the cause of all this is the fragments of that Jupiter exploration ship. I think it's safe to assume so. It's an incident of great significance. We humans have encountered an unknown entity. Yet we don't even know its characteristics. If it can fuse with another object and rapidly reproduce, we have to hurry. Yes, you're right. Just imagine you're just, you know, having a vibing day, and a fucking piece of metal just attaches to you and starts turning you to metal. That's fucked up. How are you feeling, Louise? Ah, Saji. Looks like you're stabilized. I haven't had any more seizures, but they still haven't let me out. Don't rush things, Louise. Take all the time you need to recover. K. Damn, hit him with the K. Ugh. Ah. Louise! No, stay away. Louise, calm down. No! What's wrong, Louise? A power outage? No! Something terrifying is coming! Terrifying? Dot dot dot. Who are you? Dot dot dot. Stay away! Stay away! Stay away! No! Stay away! Saji! Saji! No! No! Stop! Don't come any closer! Bang! That was a warning. Next time I'll hit you. Setsuna? Dot, dot. Ribbon's all mark. Damn, dude just got shot in the head. Head on, apply directly to the forehead. Ribbon's all mark, what are you doing here? What the? What's going on, Setsuna? I have no either. No idea either, but... Extraterrestrial living metal shapeshifter, ELS. What in the world are they? Are you thinking about something again? Are you sure? Gunshots usually are the right answer. Trust me. How can I not be? If that exploration ship was filled with unknown metallic entities, like the report says, there's no way a chance this could happen again. There won't be another accident like that. If there was such a thing, it would mean Earth is totally under attack by some evil space aliens. When I'm with you, I feel foolish for thinking about things so seriously. Hehehe. General! Gah, what is it? A section of those facilities has begun operating on its own. An unknown hatch in the satellite side. Open, then. Are you sure? Dude, there's a lot of fucking dialogue right now, man. Oh, yo! Legitty. Like, I started this
Mission like half an hour ago, and fucking still in dialogue.
Mr. Haptism. Miss Perry's. Long time no see. You've changed quite a bit, Milena.
Melina.
That hairstyle really suits you. I'm transforming into a real woman.
Good on you, Melina. Be the you you want to be.
Setsuna. What about Saji and Louise?
The Federation government evacuated them to a quantum brainwave isolation facility.
The new administration made the right call. Now, about that thing I requested. Yes, about that. The ribbons all mark that Setsuna saw, or rather a person that he saw, was a crew member of a manned Jupiter exploration project some 130 years ago.
Felt.
Right behind the scenes, the manned exploration project also carried out development of the GN drive. It's entirely possible that there was a ribbons type in innovator board, and he was absorbed by that metallic alien entity. That would be the likely explanation. According to Vader's information, similar incidents are happening on Earth. What on Earth could those aliens be after? I don't know. In fact, we don't even know if they have a will of their own.
The E-sensors have detected something. There is an object approaching the ship.
What's that?
What have we got?
Whomstiv we gotteth. Oh. That's a big spaceship. Is that a Federation transport ship?
No.
No, then what is it? Melania, find out which vessels fit the silhouette. Right away. The ship almost resembles registration number 9374.
Huh?
Jupiter exploration ship Europa?
That can't be. Ship that's been destroyed? I'm taking the Gundam.
Understood. Prepare all Gundams for launch.
Roger.
Opening Potomac hatches 1, 2, and 3. Increasing linear cannon port voltage. Transferring launch timing to Mr. Stratos.
Alright, Gundams are Banya.
Lock on Stratos, targeting and firing. Hey, we get more. Ooh. Sorry about this, Marie. It's okay. This is what we heard. I will also be a target of the aliens.
You can't be a burden to the people aboard this ship.
Thank you, Marie.
Launch preparations complete.
Roger, Gundam Haru. Alleluia, Haptism. Soma Perry's commencing interception operation. These fucking names, dude.
Setsuna, I'm sure you already know this, but we've added particle tanks to the 00 Razor. Place of solar reactors as emergency measure. You must go easy on the suit, Roger.
Double Eraser, Setsuna FSA.
Honestly, I'm just gonna sit here and just go blah 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 names.
That's it.
We're gonna fight the big ship. Gonna yeehaw it to the great beyond.
Dunny? What this?
The aliens!
Whatever they're planning, I'm not letting them get any further.
Follow the pride!
Prioritize destruction of enemy targets. Roger.
Why not? I'll bring these dudes out.
No time for hesitation.
ガンダムハルート目標へ起床する。
Damn, delete them all.
Look at this attack. I'm curious.
Using the scissor bits. I love funnel weapons.
Oh my god. Alright. Hey, we got one. Just endlessly gonna just demolish these. Charge. Yeah, kill all the things. Pew pew.
I'm also trying to speed this because I have to go eat food.
That there. Level up all the characters, level up all the suits. And move your mark. All these dudes up. Thank you. Evade all of these dudes. Oh. Boom, shit gone. Destroy that. Hell yeah, dude. Victory Royale. All those little dudes around. Oh no, they're doing stuff. Hello. My dude's leaving the front line. What in the world? Hmm? What's happening here? Oh, is this, Gah! Raphael! Prepare to eradicate all targets. Oh, how is this possible? Mr. Noriega, that suit! Yes, he's come to help us. All Gundam use, focus on getting rid of the fragments headed for the Earth Sphere. Roger. Alright. Deuteria Erde, but how? As an innovator, I'm able to transfer my consciousness into a living terminal. But it appears we don't have time to enjoy our reunion. You're right. Double O Razor. Resuming the mission. What the fuck? Oh, he's got Trans Am! Yo, Trans Am is fucking legit. So I'm told, anyway. To the yee-hawing all these fucking random space aliens to the great beyond. Bam! Explosion! Let's continuously just counterattack and kill them all. At this rate, I'm gonna get fucking this done. They can't hit me, I'm too skilled. Too much power. That's to the production list. God damn, dude. book screen. Load accuracy. Let's send out everybody. Oh, about to sneeze. Oof. Fuck it up. Nice. Everybody's leveling up. Nice, nice. Oh my god, he just survived. Oh, here, attack. Battle axe, support with you. Ah, alright, that suit's gone. Oh, that suit's not gone. Okay. Hit all these dudes and we'll see the Trans Am attack. Let's take a look at Trans Am. Oh wow, it's two Gundams together. That's pretty legit-y. Damn. Explosions. Trans Am's nice. Go around murdering everything. Counter attack, kill that. Attack, kill that. Counter attack, kill that. Counter attack with that. Counter attacks, all the counter attacks, kill everything. Nice. Getting all the production. Endless production. Good lord. Yes, it's dead.
All right. Nice.
Melee combat level 4.
I believe it's in level 3 melee combat. That's pretty nice.
Supercharged.
And dead.
F in the chat.
Move everybody really far.
Move you down here. Attack with the... Blow up everything.
Let's continuously destroy more enemies.
Oh, fuck. I hit move all. I didn't mean to hit move all, but oh well.
Oh, we're nearly done wiping out these enemies. And I'm really dying for some dinner right now.
This real quick. Ba 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 da ba 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 ba.
Look! I will be just passing everybody off to somebody else when I eventually, you know. Go for dinner. So, yeah. Sound. Come back. There you go, Sound. Boom, and they all die. Bam. Alright, this is the end of the mission. Can I go get food? Setsuna, why did you attack the LS's? ELS's? The Federation government is now referring to the alien entity as ELS's. Setsuna, explain why you did not attack the LS's. I don't know. You don't know? Are you serious? It seems your intuition as an innovator stopped you. Here with the use of Vader's information, we're unable to determine ELS's objectives. We felt something for them, and subconsciously reacted to it. In other words, ELS's do have a will of their own. ELS. So many points. Money. Hell yeah. And we got new get information for complete that. We got all of these fun nights stuff, and we got these for Chief Tiggle Counts, clear the stage, register Raphael Gundam, some more stuff. And now I can actually come here and alright, let's bring everybody's back. And everybody's leveling up. Get more cooldown items. Should also get me Roger that. And now, yes, a nice stockpile of cooldown items. Alright. Let me just make sure I save. Alright. So, I've got to go have dinner, which means I will be ending the stream today. Well, right now. But, who am I going to raid? Who is online? I'll pass you off to Vumu. Because Vumu is very nice. They're also eating, but hey. Oh, are they eating? I don't know. Let's go take a look. I'll just pass you along anyway, because I gotta go eat, and I like watching Vumu's streams, and I hope you guys like watching Vumu's streams, so we're just gonna start raiding Vumu. So, yeah, I hope you guys have a good time, and I will be catching you later. So, yeah, bye.